ba 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 ba.
Oh, today is Cuban Sandwich Day.
No way, really?
Oh, that's good, isn't it?
Yes.
That's my favorite sandwich. It's ham, roast beef. Sometimes I put a little pineapple on that, pickle, mustard. It's really good, right, Barry? I mean, you can't go wrong with
Cuban
sandwich.
I thought there was
some
pork involved there. I mean, some...
Yeah, the ham,
well,
right?
Like
a different kind of pork meat?
Pulled pork or something like that? Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah, maybe we've had different Cuban sandwiches.
Yeah, yeah.
Game. I know that there's two different kinds of meat on that thing, but that's good eating. If you're looking for something for lunch today, I've got two things for you. It's Cuban Sandwich Day, and it's also Sponge Cake Day. So there you have your entree and your dessert. Done. Nail it. It's also Hug Your Sweetheart Day today. So, you know, do that too. I can't hug your sweetheart. I'll hug my sweetheart. I will get in trouble if I hug your sweetheart. Okay, so just want to avoid that if we can. But, Cuban Sandwich Day. Get out there and take that in for lunch today. If you can find a good Cuban sandwich, you can't go wrong. AM 1450, FM 99.3, this is KNSI. Welcome back to the show. You've heard a lot about the new schedule for St. Cloud Apollo students for the month of September while they attempt to clean up from the damage from a fire. They had a number of classrooms that were damaged by smoke. One classroom was damaged by the actual flames, but it's put a crimp on space. And so now, in order to negotiate that, they're going to switch to an A-B format of schedule. Whereas, if you're a freshman or a sophomore, you'll attend schools on A days. And if you're a junior or a senior, you're going to go through virtual learning, meaning that you're going to learn remotely on a device. Then the next day, which is a B day, will flip that. Juniors and seniors will come to school and be physically in the classroom, and the A students, the freshmen and sophomore students, they will virtual learn. Now, when we first talked about this last week, there were a lot of questions. How will we make sure that students are learning? How will we make sure that they're in class versus playing video games, not at home at all, doing what they're going to do? Those are they're good questions to ask because this is a new way of learning, but I'm fascinated by this ability to deliver education. There could be some future applications to this that are good for the students and the taxpayers. Lori Posch is with us. Lori Posch is the Executive Director of Learning and Teaching for District 742. She's going to attempt to teach us what virtual learning is. Lori, welcome. Thank you for joining us on KNSI today.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
So I got to tell you, Lori, I'm excited by this. Now, obviously, the questions you can understand are valid questions. This is new. It's different. And so people are going to wonder how exactly we make sure kids are learning what they're supposed to learn. That being said, I'm fascinated by the potential here. So tell us what you can about virtual learning and how it does what the classroom does.
Well, first of all, I love what you were just saying, because we always look at any challenge that comes our way as an opportunity. And we, too, are really excited about the opportunities that this is bringing us to be able to explore some of the ways that we have wanted to think outside the box in terms of teaching. So when we think about virtual learning, our students will be participating in learning off-site using their school-provided computers. We're really fortunate in our district that our students have had one-to-one devices in previous years, and both our students and our teachers are familiar with a platform that we use called Schoology. So each class is set up in a Schoology account. We're really anticipating a smooth transition to this, and our Apollo staff is working diligently to ensure that the start of school is successful. So when you ask about how it will work, our teachers will have learning activities planned and posted in their Schoology accounts. Our students will then log into their account between normal school hours, so between 8:30 and 3:15, and they will correspond with their teachers, they'll participate in discussions, and or they'll hand in daily assignments that the teachers have planned. So it will still be an active learning day, they'll just be doing it via computer.
So the teachers will actually be delivering lectures or conversations like the regular classroom atmosphere. It's just that you will be at home getting those via video feed. Do I understand that right?
Not quite. They actually won't be doing the lectures virtually. They will have assignments already created.
Okay.
So it may be an assignment where students need to access their online resources and watch a video and do some responding. Through Schoology, they can interact with other students in their classroom. So it may not be with their teacher right at that moment, but it will be throughout the day, feedback from teachers, from other students, and finishing their assignments. There's online chats, there's discussions, there's a lot of ways that will ensure that the students are actively engaged in their learning that day.
Okay, that kind of answered the question for me, Lori. I was going to ask how that interaction was going to take place, but you're talking about instant messaging, online chatting, typing something into a machine, and the teachers can do that as well. Is that right?
Correct, and we can do that all through that Schoology platform.
So, again, Lori Posch is our guest. She's the Executive Director of Learning and Teaching for School District 742 in St. Cloud. We're talking about the alternate schedule and virtual learning that will take place at St. Cloud Apollo during the first month of the year while they continue to clean up from some fire damage that took place over the course of the summer. Lori, the teacher, I'm assuming, will be teaching from home. The student will be learning from home. So the classroom becomes sort of secondary in that regard. If this is successful, is this something that could be not just to clean up from fire damage, but maybe a semi-permanent or permanent way that we look at delivering education?
Well, first of all, I want to clarify that our teachers won't be at home.
So
our
they won't. Okay.
Our teachers will be at Apollo every day because they will have students in the building both days. So our teachers are working every day from Apollo. They will have some time set aside where they will check into their Schoology account. But you're right, I think every time that we have an opportunity like this, and it's something that we've already been talking with the Minnesota Department of Education about, regarding days where we have snow days, where we have some of those other opportunities, maybe days to buy back some professional development time. So we really are looking at this as a learning opportunity for us as a district, too, in how we best deliver instruction to our students. We know that we live in a digital society, and we know that our students' learning styles are changing. However, we also know that the best place for our students is with their teachers in their classroom. So this really gives us the best of both worlds.
And that maybe answers the next question. We have a caller, Dave from Santiago, is with us. He wants to ask about the school presence. I'm sure there will be some value in that, but we'll let him answer the, or rather ask the question, Lori. Dave, welcome to KNSI.
Hey, thanks for having me on. Yeah, we continually see ads on the television promoting online education for, you know, anything from K through 12 and online universities on. Now, is this going to show that, you know, we don't really need the big, huge physical presence in the future, and we need to look more towards online education and changing, you know, what we look to as an instructor or a teacher? Because now we're going to have someone who's going to be doing more of an online monitoring of students.
Dave, thank you for your question. Lori, I'm going to let you answer that, and then we'll have to wrap up. But there are going to be some people that will naturally ask, and I'm sure you're prepared for this, is this a replacement for the school building?
And my answer to that is I don't think we can ever replace schools. We can never replace that relationship that's built between our staff and our students. We do know that we have some students where the online learning is an option for them, and we have some students in our district who participate in that. But for the majority of the students, this is an enhancement to their learning. It's not a replacement of. We will always have the need for the one-to-one interactions with our teachers and our students.
Lori, thank you for your time this morning. It's a little bit too brief. We may have to discuss this as the month of September rolls on just to get an update from you to see how it's working at Apollo. Is that something you could do for us down the road?
We would be happy to do that. And we also just want to tell you thank you for reaching out and helping to get our message out to everybody in our community.
No problem, Lori. No problem, Lori. Thank you for your time. Again, that's Lori Posch, the Executive Director of Learning and Teaching. Some of you are right to suggest, is this the replacement for the school presence? We've spent the balance of our day today together talking about school security. Well, one can hardly argue against the idea that a school is a whole lot more secure if there isn't a school. I, for one, would struggle with the idea of students never going to a school building and learning to be around other students. There are some social aspects to that interaction that are probably not going to be able to be taught at home in front of a computer. But, you know, this every other day type thing, Like we mentioned last week, if you need a $100 million building so everybody can go to school every day, and now you can have it so everybody goes to school every other day, can you get by with $50 million? That's where the efficiencies to the taxpayer really can be discussed, along with, you know, body counts. Can teachers do more things and teach more classes? Because they're only there with that group of students, anyway, every other day. And then they're online teaching another group of students. Outside the Box with Ox, it's up right now on KNSI.